And it's electrifying here in Maple Leaf Gardens at the moment. Here we go for the faceoff. Leafs have Stanley, Kelly, Pulford, Harton, and Armstrong. Stanley talks to Kelly. The puck is dropped. Kelly at the Pulford. Pulford gets left Armstrong. Armstrong waits, takes it, just goal! A wild finish. The players jump on the ice. Here it is on the weak line. The Leafs get the faceoff. Over to Armstrong from Pulford. He takes aim, one man back. It's in there. Look at this action on the ice. 47 seconds left to play. 3-1 Toronto. Armstrong, the Leafs captain, who is possibly playing his last game in a Maple Leaf uniform. Of course, we're not sure about that. But he gets a goal into the empty net, and everybody is up and standing and cheering. All the Leaf fans here at the Garden go wild. Programs on the ice. The players swarmed over the boards. This game is not finished.
Not by a long
shot. That would appear to be the insurance goal the Leafs were looking for. Very, very important faceoff. Sawchuk at the far end of the rink with his head way down over his goal stick as he feels that release of tension and pressure.
Toronto goal, scored by number 10, Armstrong. Assist, number 20, Pulford, and number 26, Stanley. The time, 19:13.
There's Terry Sawchuk. And they've won so many key games by the score of 3-1. There are still 47 seconds left to play. But that would appear to be the goal the Leafs needed to win the Stanley Cup.
Getting set for the faceoff at center ice, a scoring play. Armstrong from Pulford and Stanley at 19.
Official correction on the second Toronto goal, scored by number 18, Pappen. Assist number 12, Stempowski, and number 20, Pulford. And official correction on the last Toronto goal, scored by number 10, Armstrong. Assist number 20, Pulford, and number 4, Kelly.
The puck is cleared into the Leafs zone with 34 seconds remaining. Hillman stops. Around on the boards for Pulford. Pulford can't get it out. Cornoyer for Duff. Pulford does get it over the line. Going down with Armstrong. One man back. They're closing in Armstrong. Back to Pulford. And Worsley came out. It came right in front of the net. 14 seconds. 13. It's a pass up for Richard. Stopped by Marcel Cronenberg. Pulford flicking it down the ice to the over the blue line. 3 seconds. 2, 1. The game is over. The Toronto Maple Leafs have won the Stanley Cup.
What a tremendous hockey game this was. Fantastic. Look at the Leafs. Mob Terry Sawchuk. Johnny Bower was one of the first men over the boards. 27, Mahovlich. There's George Armstrong, who scored that insurance goal. Mike Walton is down there. Bobby Bond, Eddie Shack, some of the players who did not get into the game. And now the gallant Montreal Canadiens are lining up. They put on a tremendous show here tonight. Terry Sawchuk frustrated them early in the hockey game. Two goals in the second period might have killed their hopes, but they fought on right up until the last minute of play when George Armstrong scored into that empty net to kill any chance of a tie. Hunch Imlach is out there shaking hands with his own players. and with Toe Blake just at the blue line. Toe Blake comes over and congratulates Punch Imlach. Stemkowski throws Imlach's hat high in the air. You see the players moving along, shaking hands with each other. Red Kelly and Tim Horton embrace each other. Terry Sawchuk skating slowly to the Leaf bench. One of the first men to head for the Leaf dressing room, right behind Bobby Bond. Now the Canadians have made their way, most of them, off to the dressing room. John Ferguson and John Beliveau, the last two to leave the ice. The Stanley Cup is at center ice. It'll be presented in just a moment. Meanwhile, the photographers are all
around.
Ladies
and gentlemen, here's Mr. Clarence Campbell, the president of the National Hockey League, will now present the Stanley Cup to the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Doug Moore has placed the microphone at center ice. Here's Clarence Campbell.
Responsibility to present the Stanley Cup to the Maple Leaf Hockey Club for the 11th time. Before making the formal presentation, I would like to express on your behalf to both teams our warm thanks and congratulations on a very splendid season. And now I'll ask the captain of the Toronto Club to come forward and receive the trophy.
George Armstrong with his son, I believe that's Brian, comes along with him. He'll get his picture in the papers tomorrow, Bill. Clarence Campbell, president of the National Hockey League, presenting the Stanley Cup to Captain George Armstrong, who asks his son to help him hold it high. And George says, come on in here, fellas. This was a team effort all the way. The players, including Larry Jeffrey on crutches, who missed the final series because of a cartilage operation. You might see him in there somewhere in that throng. All group around now to get their pictures taken. Marcel Pronovo, one of the heroes of this playoff, in the front row. Ronnie Ellis off to the side. There's Larry Jeffrey to the right of your screen. Alan Stanley just behind. And Hillman and Stemkowski. How they emerged as a tremendous hockey team late in the season and in the playoffs. Now Marcel Pronovo skates to the Leafs dressing room, and some of the Leafs begin to leave the ice. Al Smith was out there, too.